This is pretty awesome. Charleston holds a very special place in my heart. My wife is from Jacksonville, Florida, and I'm from Raleigh, North Carolina. And so the halfway point for us to meet when we first started dating was Charleston. And so we used to come here every other weekend, and I've walked by this place a million times and never even peered inside. And we walked in today, and we just all looked at each other like, this is gonna be cool. You know, they took us down to like, showed us a bunch of old guns and shit. It was awesome. It's like, yeah, these guns are from like the 1700s. That's cool. So I got some songs for you. I'm from a little place called Reedsville, North Carolina, right in the middle of the Piedmont region of North Carolina. And you don't really do much in Reedsville. You either farm tobacco or you manufacture tobacco, but you're somehow involved in the tobacco business. So my grandfather, he was a tobacco farmer and then growing up, and then he served our country in World War II, and he came home pretty high on life, man. They won the war. Everything's good for America. And then he realized that he was an unskilled, untalented, uneducated person in America. And the American dream didn't matter to him. He got a job at the American Tobacco Company, and for 42 years, 12 hours a day, 5 days a week, he sat at a machine and watched cigarettes roll off that machine. And literally, just shitty, minimum wage work. He did it for 42 years. Never once complained because he had kids and he had a wife. And I wanted to write this song about kind of the disillusionment of American dream. And this is for my grandpa. And it's a song called The American Tobacco Company. Start screaming, wanting something more, and I come crashing back to reality before the walls close in on me and crush me to the core. Yeah, I work my fingers to the bone just to have a little bit of something I can call my own. Summer of 45, not a single place was higher than my cousin knew a guy. Now I sit here on the line and watch these big machines crush my hopes and dreams into palm walls and lucky strikes. Yeah, I work my fingers to the bone just to have a little bit of something I can call my own. At the American Tobacco Company, at the American Tobacco Company. Pull yourself up by the bootstraps, they say, and you can't live the American dream. But all those days I spent thinking in the South Pacific, hell, this ain't how I thought that dream would be. So every single morning I walk into this building and I think about my children and the life they ought to lead. And I try my best not to look back, just stare up at that smokestack, and my troubles fade away.